With Apple set to launch its newest operating system, macOS 15 Sequoia, almost any day now, many are wondering which Mac models will be supported and how long until an unsupported version is available for older Macs. Officially speaking, Sequoia will be available for MacBook Pros and Mac Minis made in 2018 and later, MacBook Airs from 2020 and later, and iMacs and Mac Pros from 2019 and later. iMac Pros from 2017 are supported for Sequoia, but they're the only Mac made before 2018 that's supported, meaning any Mac made in 2016 or earlier will not be supported for updating to Sequoia. Does that mean that you'll never be able to run a version of Sequoia on your older Mac? Of course not. The talented and rebellious developers at Dortania have already begun working on an unsupported version of Sequoia to install on older Macs using OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So it's safe to say that most Macs made in either 2013 or later will be able to run an unsupported version of Sequoia shortly after its official release. It's important to note that even on supported Macs, certain features of Sequoia, such as Apple's new built-in AI, Apple Intelligence, and the new live audio transcription feature in Notes, will only be available for Macs with Apple Silicon chips. The new iPhone mirroring feature will only be available on Intel Macs with a T2 security chip, and of course, Macs with Apple Silicon chips. This makes it unlikely that these features will make it into OpenCore's unsupported version of Sequoia, but many users are still holding out hope that Dortania will find a way to get Apple Intelligence running even without Apple Silicon chips. Honestly, it's unlikely, and even if they did get it running, the performance would be greatly hindered due to hardware limitations. Apple Intelligence makes use of Apple Neural Engine, a processing unit on Apple Silicon Macs that makes machine learning more efficient. OpenCore does their best, but there are times when hardware limitations simply can't be bypassed. Which is why you won't see many unsupported versions of Sequoia for Macs made before 2014, the year that Apple released Metal graphics, which required a significant boost in processing power from the GPU. OpenCore has been very clear and transparent about the challenges in developing versions of macOS that require Metal graphics and that some older GPUs simply can't keep up. In my book, if you can squeeze 10 years out of a computer, you're doing pretty well, so no complaints here. If you're on a supported Mac, you should see an optional update come up in your Apple menu within the next couple months offering you to upgrade to macOS 10.15 Sequoia. If you're on an unsupported Mac, keep an eye out for the unsupported launch announcement on the Dortania website, which should come shortly after the official launch. Once it's out, I'll put a video right here showing you the exact steps on how to upgrade to an unsupported version of Sequoia. And hey guys, anytime you're doing an update, remember to do a backup. You know the drill. That's all I've got for you for today. I'm Anson Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.